What's up, everyone? Welcome to today's video. If you're watching this, obviously you're looking for ways to market your construction business or any service-based business for that matter. So that's exactly what we're going to talk about. For those who don't know me, my name is Michael Tandarich and I run a marketing agency and I've been doing it for 10 plus years. And we help our clients with websites, branding, and advertising. Now, construction and landscaping and any other type of service business is some of the clients that we've worked with over the past 10 years. And so we have a lot of experience with marketing these types of businesses. And to say that those niches are very competitive is kind of an understatement. So in today's video, let's dive into exactly how to market your construction business and actually stand out from your competition. Now, I'm gonna go over three things to market your construction business. And those three things are very specific. You probably haven't heard of them in other videos. But before I do that, I wanna make sure that you have a good baseline for your marketing. What I mean by that is you could have the best marketing and advertising in the world and you could spend hundreds of thousands of dollars on that. But if your website is poorly built and not a good user interface and it's very hard to manage and looks very unprofessional, or your logo looks unprofessional, or your customer service side of stuff, so if someone comes to your website and tries calling you or filling out a form is really bad, then none of that is going to matter. One of the main things that we do with our marketing agency is when someone comes to us and asks for their marketing to be done or their advertising, we take a look at their website and their customer service and their logo and branding first. And the reason we do that is, like I said, we can drive all that marketing and advertising to your website, but if your website is poorly built and your branding isn't professional and your customer service is very poor, none of it's really gonna matter and you're not gonna get the best bang for your buck of this marketing advertising if that stuff is in a poor spot. So if you need help with that, I left a link in the description for our marketing agency and we'd be happy to talk more. All right, that being said, let's jump into those three things. Again, assuming that your website, your branding, and your customer service is in a good spot, these three things will help you with your marketing. Okay, the first one I would suggest is doing mailers, but I'm not talking about the actual mailers that everyone else does where they're like a postcard and it's got some graphics on one side and the graphics on the other side, or the door hanging mailers. I'm not talking about those at all. That's what your competition is doing. You wanna be completely standing out from that. What I'm talking about when I say mailers is handwritten letters. But Michael, I don't have time for that. Look, I get it. You're running a business and you don't have time to do handwritten letters. That's totally okay. That's why there's plenty of businesses out there that actually do handwritten letters for you. They have machines that write it all out for you. You just give them the description and the copy that you want. Sometimes they even come up with it themselves and you can just have them do it. On top of that, if you don't want to go the route of having another company do it, there are plenty of machines that you can purchase on Amazon. I'll link a couple of them below that you can purchase and hook up and write out handwritten letters. It does it all for you. You just tell the machine what copy you wanna put and then it does it all for you. And the reason I'm saying this is, like I said, your competition is sending out those nice graphic mailers, the door hangers and all that stuff. Those are just in your face marketing pieces. Customers know that. Clients know that if you send it to someone's house randomly, they know that that's a marketing piece and it immediately gets thrown in the trash. But if you're sending handwritten letters out to people, again, I understand they're not fully handwritten, but if you're sending those out to people, you're giving that personal touch that your competition is not doing. And it immediately makes your piece stand out from everyone else. On top of that, not many people get handwritten letters anymore. And there's a whole generation that used to do that all the time. And if you really want to add that personal touch and make yourself stand out from your competition, doing handwritten letters is the way to do it. On top of that, I'll throw this in there too. If you go with another company that does the handwritten letters and stuff, they have huge databases where you can pull exactly the information that you want, the exact people that you want to send this mailer to based on their demographic, based on their salary, all that kind of stuff. So going with one of those companies might be a good route. And I'll put a couple of those in the description too. Anyhow, that would be number one is doing mailers. But again, making them handwritten and adding that personal touch to it. Okay, number two is sending personalized videos. I can almost guarantee that no one in your competition is doing this. And the reason being is it takes time and effort, but by doing this, this makes you stand out extremely from everyone else because they don't want to put that time and effort in. So what happens is a lot of times in construction businesses and any service-based business, you kind of get to a point where you stop hustling from the beginning and get into the referral period where everyone's just sending you a referral. That's great. However, you're not going out and getting those leads and getting those people. And if you really want to stand out from everyone else, then what you should do is do it in a way that no one else is doing it. And sending personalized videos is the way to do it. Now, let me go over exactly how to do this. Instead of going out and just hitting random people and saying, hey, I offer construction services, like hire me. What you want to do is you want to find realtors in your area and send them personalized videos. So going on real estate websites, finding realtors on Google, and then going and finding their Instagram account. And by doing that, what you want to do is you want to follow them on Instagram, and then you want to send them a video like this. Hey, my name is Michael. I saw that you live in the same area as I do. I run a construction business, and knowing that you're a realtor, I would love to meet up with you and have a coffee, talk a little bit more about the area, some stuff you're interested in. And then I'd also love to talk to you about how we can pass referrals on to each other. I know being a realtor, you probably know a lot of people and you're really good at what you do. So if you would like to talk more or schedule some time for a coffee, I'd love to talk more. Thanks. And by doing that, you just sent a personalized video to a realtor, and they have a huge database of people that they work with, people that are homeowners, people that are building houses, that are in the construction space, might need construction, and you just started a relationship with a realtor. Now, I'm not saying every single one of them are going to reach back out to you and have that cup of coffee with you, but the ones that do, and if you have a great conversation with them, are going to end up having a great relationship with you, and you're going to be able to build a huge contact list off of them. And on top of that, you can even negotiate in something where if you send them any kind of referrals, you get a percentage of whatever house that referral sells or buys with that realtor. Look, being a business owner, you have to figure out every single way to make money, and sending referrals and getting a percentage of that is another way of making money. Point is that's the baseline for it, and sending personalized videos. I do that for my marketing agency, and I have to say, probably I close about 70 to 80% of the videos that I send out. So for every 5 videos I send out, I land about, 3 to 4 meetings, and then about 2 to 3 of those I land. And again, I know that takes time. I know it takes time to go out and get that cup of coffee, but if you do that a couple times a month, you're starting to build your relationship with people in the community, new people that are coming in, and will eventually pay out in dividends. All right, number 3, and this one you've definitely heard from other people, is doing some kind of ad campaigns. Reason being I throw this in there is it's very important to kind of play a defensive mode along with all the offense that you're playing. What I mean by that is, let's say your business is called Jim's Construction in Atlanta, Georgia. If someone types that into Google and you aren't running Google ads, what's gonna happen is, if you have a good website, your website is gonna show up on their Jim's Construction in Atlanta, Georgia. However, if your competition is savvy, which a lot of people are, they can go after your personalized keyword. So what that means is Michael's Construction in Atlanta, Georgia can run ads to your keyword Jim's Construction in Atlanta, Georgia, and their ad would show up first before yours. Thus, if you actually get a referral, there's a chance that people are gonna get captured by Michael's Construction Company instead of Jim's. So if you're gonna run any kind of ads at all, playing that defensive game is very important. Along with that, if you're gonna be running Google ads and playing that defensive mode, you might as well play offense too and go after keywords like construction company in Atlanta, Georgia, or where can I find a construction company in Atlanta, Georgia. The reason Google ads are so powerful for service-based companies and construction-based companies is because that is the exact time that that client or customer is looking for your service. See, when they're on Facebook, they're kind of just scrolling around, just hanging out. And so hitting them with an ad there doesn't really make sense. But hitting them with an ad on Google at the exact moment that they're looking for someone in construction is the best way to go about utilizing your ad strategy. I will say this, running Google ads is one of the things my marketing agency helps clients with. So if you need help with that, I left a link to the marketing agency in the description below. All right, so those are 3 ways of marketing your construction business that I highly suggest. And again, I'm coming from the aspect of I run a marketing agency, and I've been doing this for 10 plus years with a bunch of other construction companies and other service-based companies. So if you have any questions at all, leave a comment below. And if you subscribe, I would greatly appreciate it. I come out with videos for business owners on how to market and advertise their business. And I would love for you to subscribe and join us in that, and gain value from all the other videos I'm gonna be putting out. Thanks for taking the time to watch the video. I'll see you in the next one.